Hello students, good time to all. I am Chandan Kumar Pradhan. Welcome to YouTube channel Chandan Physics. In this video, we are going to discuss line spectra of hydrogen atom. Let's begin. In the previous video lecture, we have already discussed about an atomic spectra, that is absorption spectra and emission spectra. Here it is an example of atomic spectra, that is simple hydrogen atom. When the electron in a hydrogen atom jumps from higher energy level to the lower energy level, there will be a difference in energy. The difference of energies of the two energy levels is emitted a radiation of particular wavelength, and which is called a spectral line. In case of simple hydrogen, that is the nucleus, these are the orbits with electrons revolving. N is equal to 1, N is equal to 2, N is equal to 3, like this. This is the electron revolving around that nucleus. If that electron absorbs an energy, so it passes from that ground state to excited state, and here we see one type of spectral line which is called absorption spectra. In the same way, when that electron jumps from excited state to that of lower energy level, again another type of spectral we see. The type of spectral we called emission spectra. So when electron that ground state to that of excited state, this is absorption spectra. Again, when electron jumps from higher energy level to that of lower energy level, in that particular situation we see another type of spectrum, that is emission spectrum. In both the cases, the spectral we see, that is in form of line, and we call it as line spectrum. Why that type of spectral line we see in case of hydrogen atom? The wavelength of such spectral line depends upon the energy associated with the two energy levels between which transition of electron takes place. If transition of electrons from N1 to N3, then what be the wavelength that depends upon the energy associated with that of N1 and energy associated with that of N3? As we already discussed in that previous video, the energy difference is equal to h nu, that is integral multiple of Planck's constant into frequency. So the wavelength of spectral line depends upon the energy associated with two energy levels between which transition electrons takes place. For transmission of electron between two energy levels, the spectral lines of different wavelengths are obtained. If the transition from energy level 1 to energy level 2, one type of spectral line. If the transition from energy level 1 to energy level 3, again another type of spectral line. So these spectral lines have different in their wavelength. That's why the spectral lines are found to fall into a number of spectral series. a number of spectral series we notice in case of that hydrogen atom. So that series, the various series of hydrogen spectrum can be explained from equation, that equation from Bohr's theory. Bohr's theory of hydrogen atom. In upcoming videos, we discuss about Bohr's theory of atomic model and example of hydrogen atom. From that, we have an equation. That equation is nu bar is equal to 1 by lambda is equal to a constant, that is R, 1 divided by n I square minus n O square. We obtain a number of spectral series. So, what be the number of spectral series? That can be decided by that equation, where R is a constant. That constant is called Rydberg constant, and that value 1.097 into 10 to the power 7 meter inverse. Ni, the inner orbit. No, which is outer orbit. Lambda, wavelength, wavelength of that spectral line. Next, nu bar, that is wave number, wave number. So, what be the number of spectral series we obtain? That can be decided by that particular equation. Let come to that hydrogen atom. In case of hydrogen atom, if we try n is equal to 1, this is n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4, n is equal to 5, n is equal to 6, and so on. So on. If the spectral lines corresponding to the transition of electron from some higher energy state to that of lower energy state, whereas the lower energy state is n equal to 1. The transitions from higher energy level to that of 1. In that case, the series we obtained, that spectral line we see, is called Lyman series, that is called Lyman series, whereas ni is equal to 1 and no 2 3 4, like this. And that type of spectral lines lie on that of ultraviolet region. We see that type of spectral line in ultraviolet region. In electromagnetic radiation, there is ultraviolet region. So, in case of hydrogen atom, when the transition occurred from higher energy level to that of lower energy level at n is equal to 1, that the spectral series corresponds to Lyman series. That Lyman series we notice in case of ultraviolet region. Next, if the transition from higher energy state to n is equal to 2, n is equal to 2. N is equal to 2. That type of spectral series is called Balmer series. It is called Balmer series. Where Ni is equal to 2 and No from 3, 4, 5 and so on. And this type of series you notice in case of visible region means in our naked eye we can see that Balmer series for that hydrogen atom spectrum. Next series, when the transition from higher energy level to that of lower energy level, that lower energy level correspond to n is equal to 3. N is equal to 3. That series is called Paschen series. Paschen series. Whereas Ni is equal to 3 and No 4, 5, 6 and so on. We notice that type of series in infrared region. Infrared region. Next type of series, transition from higher to that of lower. Lower corresponds to n is equal to 4. N is equal to 4. This is the 4. That series is called bracket series. This is called bracket series. Whereas Ni is equal to 4. And NO stands for 5, 6, 7, like this. Again, that is also we see in infrared region. Another series we notice, transition from higher to that of lower, and that lower energy level corresponds to N is equal to 5. N is equal to 5. Is called Pfaffner series. Pfaffner series. Whereas Ni as 5, No 6, 7, 8, like this. That type of series again we see in infrared region. Infrared region. So the number of series we notice in case of hydrogen atom spectrum as Lyman series, Balmer series, Pasten series, Brackett series and Friffen series, then what be the number of spectral lines we see, that can be decided by the equation given by Bohr's theory of hydrogen atom. As nu bar is equal to 1 by lambda is equal to r whole into 1 divided by ni square minus 1 divided by no square. R Rydberg constant, ni inner orbit, outer orbit, lambda wavelength, nu dash, that is the wave number. On that basis, then if we calculate what be the Lyman series, we put the value of ni is equal to 1 and no, whatever may be that transition we notice. Accordingly, what be the number of wave numbers, what be the number of spectral lines we see in case of Lyman series is decided by that particular equation. So here, with the help of this video lecture, we discuss about the concept line spectra of hydrogen atom. What is line spectra? Spectral line. A simple example as hydrogen atom. Why the transition occurred? Then the number of spectral series we derived by using that equation, and the spectral series you notice in case of hydrogen atom: Lyman, Balmer, Pasten, Brackett, Friffen. So, with this useful and informative notes, let me wind up the session. Thank you.